So very 21st century, you're probably listening to me on some kind of portable stereo. Maybe you're sitting on the back of the bus, or it's running up your sleeve and you're across from your boss, or you're sitting in your bedroom on your own with the lights down low. I'd like to teach you four simple words, so that the next time you come to a show, you could sing those words back at me like they're the only words that you know. I want to dance. I want to dance. I want lust and love and a smattering of romance, but I'm no good at dancing, and yet I have to do something. Tonight I'm gonna play it straight, I'm gonna take my chance. I want to dance.
Come on, London! Calling for friends, condescend with a smile. Yeah, but this is my culture, man, this is my home. The dark colored bus is gonna wrap the gate. Yeah, the doors are intimate and the show starts to late. A few precious hours in the space of our own. When the band comes, I'm the only thing I really know. I wanna dance. I wanna dance. I want lust and love and a snatch to bring all the mask. But I'm not gonna dance, yeah, I have to do something. The scene to some shortage. Oh, it's all sex, drugs and sins. Another exorcist and skins. But it's okay, cause I don't really mean it. I want bands who had to work with their keep. Drawn with 1,000 miles of pain, that's your no sleep. Sleeping on the floor at a stranger's place. Hungry just to do it all again the next day. Oh, I wanna dance. I wanna dance. I want lust and love and expect to bring all the bands. But I'm no good at dancing. Yeah, I have to do something. Tonight I'm gonna play it straight. I'm gonna take my shot. I'm fist, no fight.
No fist, no fight.
Our transgender world, some people think like us. We just want our own space to dance, man. No favors, no fuss. Young bloods running violent. We are building ourselves a house with the roof is on fire. We're gonna put it out. Forget about your bitching and remember that you're blessed. Pockets of the kitchen, now we're fitting with the rest. Alright, somebody told me the music with guitars was going out of fashion. I had to laugh. The shit wasn't fashionable when I fell in love. The hipsters move on, why should I give a fuck? I wanna dance. I wanna dance. I want me some lust, some love, and a smattering of old time romance. And to the north, never to be caught. To the south, my time is running out. Ever since my childhood, I've been scared, I've been afraid of being trapped by circumstances, staying in one place. So I always keep a small bag full of clothes carefully stored. Somewhere secret, somewhere safe, somewhere close to the door. Well, I've traveled many countries, washed my feet in many seas. I drunk with grifters here in London and with punks in old DC. And I've driven across deserts, driven by the irony that only being shackled to the road could ever I be free. And to the north, never to be caught. To the south, and my time is running out. I felt old before my time, but now I'll keep the age away by burning up the miles in the air, by filling up my days. And the nights, a thousand nights I've played, a thousand more to go. Take a breath and steal myself. Next 1,000 shows. To the east, the road beneath my feet. To the west, well, I haven't got there yet. And to the north, never to be caught. To the south, and my time is running out. Here we go. show number 1,379. This song's called Peggy Sang the Blues. Peggy came to me in my sleep in the middle of the night on a Friday night last week. She whispered, "Hush, John, and don't be scared. Got me a few words of wisdom that I came back to share." She said, "It doesn't matter where you come from, it matters where you go. No one gets to remember the things they didn't do." I said, "Peggy, won't you stay here for a while? Drink whiskey, we could play cards, and we could get wild." She said, "We'll play poker, we'll play for keeps. I only play angels, they be in the never let me cheat. Doesn't matter where you come from, matters where you go. Hey, no one gets to me. This life, things they didn't do." And you can say I had a good start, and you can say I had class, and you can say that I was born beneath the ceiling made of glass. But I always kept an open house, yet I always did right by my friends. When I got to St. Peter's Gate, told the keeper, "I'm not the one who needs to make amends. Sing it." No one gets to remember my deathless child, so don't rest too long in bed. Peggy said, "No matter where you come from, matters where you go. No one gets to remember this loveless life, things they didn't do. Na 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 na. Peggy sang the blues, so drifted on. Well, Peggy sang the blues, so drifted on. Well, Peggy sang the blues, so drifted on. Well, Peggy sang the blues." Thank you very much. Good evening, London. How you doing? My name is Frank Turner, and this is The Sleeping Souls. Thank you so much for coming out for the show this evening. All right, so is everyone having a good time so far? How you doing? Good shit. It's our job to keep that going. I don't really believe in telling other people what to do. So these aren't really rules. These are guidelines. Here's some guidelines for the show. Let's make sure everyone's having a good time. Look out for everyone around you. Have a good time, right? If you know the words to a song, you got to fucking sing along, all right? Most importantly of all, even if you don't know the words, you can still dance your fucking asses off. This song's called Reasons Not to Be an Idiot. You're not as messed up as you think you are. Your self-absorption makes you messier. To settle down and you would feel a whole lot better deep down, just like everybody else. Not as pretty as she thinks she is. Just picture her after she's had kids. I bet she sits at home and listens to the Smiths deep down, just like everybody else. So why are you sat at home? You're not designed to be alone. Just got used to saying no. So get up in the town and get outside. It's a lovely sunny day to hide yourself. think. He's just ambitious with his arguing. He's gravitizing, yeah, and he can't hold his drink deep down, just like everybody else. Oh, I want to see you clap your hands, come on! Not as awesome as a sonic sound. I'm angry, underweight, and sketching out. I'm burning all my vanities and doubts. Get warm, just like everybody else. So why are you sat at home? Not designed to be alone. Just got used to saying no. Get up and get down and get outside. It's a lovely sunny day. So you hide yourself away. You've only got yourself to blame. Get up and get down and get outside. Amy thinks her life is lacking drama. So she cover horoscopes, they feeling calmer. So wrapped up in her invisible armor. Never got into herself. And it's okay, think of me and all my friends are just wasters. Saying I can still see through her airs and graces. Yeah, she's scared of life, won't leave any traces. Kinda like everyone else. That's not the point anyway. Oh darling, felt compelled to call you up to say. Not designed to be alone. Just got used to saying no. Get up and get down and get outside. It's a lovely sunny day to hide yourself away. You only got yourself to blame. Get up and get down and get outside. Get up and get down and get outside.
Come on!
Get up and get down and get outside. Get up and get down and get outside. Get up and get down and get outside. Get up and get down and get outside.
Brothers and sisters, have you heard the news? The storm has lifted and there's nothing to lose. So swap your confirmation for your dancing shoes, because there never was no God. Step out of the darkness and onto the streets. Forget about the fast, let's have a carnival feast. Raise up your lowered head to hear the liberation beat, because there never was no God. And there is no God. So clap your hands together. There is no God. No heaven and no hell. There is together, there is no God. So ring that victory bell. No cowering in the dark before some overbearing priest. No waiting until we die, until we restitute the meek. No blaming all our failings on imaginary peace, because there never was no God. Fighting on the land that your distant fathers told you of. No spilling blood for those who never spread a drop of love. The finger pointing justified my phantoms up above, because there never was no God. There is no God. So clap your hands together. There is no God. No heaven and no hell. There is no together. There is no God. So ring that victory bell. No, you're scared of dying, man, and I am too. But just pretending it's not happening isn't gonna see us through. If we accept that there's an end game, we haven't got much time. Then in the here and now, then we could try and do things right. We'd be our own salvation army. Together we'd
believe in all the wondrous things that mere mortals can achieve. Cause I've known beauty in the stillness of cathedrals in the day I've sung glory, hallelujah, while you wash my sins away. Now we're singing my refrain. This is what I say. I say there never was no God. There is no God. So clap your hands together. There is no God. No heaven and no hell. There is no God. We're all in this together. There is no God. So ring that victory bell. Everybody jump! There is no God. So clap your hands together. There is no God. No heaven and no hell. There is no God. We're all in this together. There is no so she can always run. Get up, shower, and half an hour she'd be gone. Keep having dreams of things I need to do, of waking up and I'm following through. But it feels like I haven't slept at all when I wake to a silence and she's facing the wall. Posters of Dylan and of Hemingway, an antique compass for a sailor's escape. She says you just can't live this way, and I close my eyes and I never say. Still having dreams, and on the worst days when it feels like life weighs 10,000 tons, I sleep with my passport, one eye on the back door, so I can always run. Get up, shower, and half an hour be gone. Come morning, you guys sing it. Just an imprint on the bed sheets. I'm by the roadside with my thumb out. The car pulls up, and Bob's driving. So I climb in. We don't say a word as we pull off into the sunrise. And these rivers of tarmac are like arteries across the country. We are blood cells. Thank you very much. I feel like we're warming up now, yeah? So today is the second show that we've ever played since Monday. And of course, on Monday, I'm hoping people know this, we had a new album come out called Tape Deck Heart. And if it's okay with you, we're going to play some new songs as the evening goes on. Is that cool? We'll play the hits as well. We're going to do Meat Loaf, Bon Jovi, Van Halen. Matt knows Van Halen. You got it, jump.
Nice.
That's the worst noise I ever made into a microphone. Anyway, but yeah, so we're going to play some new stuff. This is a song, it's about a lot of different things, but in part it's about a venue called the Astoria that used to be in central London. Anyone ever go to the Astoria? I fucking grew up going to the Astoria, I'll tell you now. Anyway, and I want to dedicate this song. One member of my crew, Mr. Dylan Barnes, fell sick a couple of days ago, and unfortunately he's not here because he's laid up, resting up, getting well again. But we are filming this for like a live webcast thing, and I'm reliably informed that he is currently watching this. So Dylan, get well soon, motherfucker. This song's called Polaroid Picture. Man, we used to be brothers, superheroes and warriors, cowboys and Indians, train drivers, everything rolling through the endless summers. But everything changes. You got married, had children, and I don't have your number. The one I can remember is a place you used to live with your parents. But in the stillness of the moment, it takes a Polaroid picture to capture our faces forever. The world is trying to touch on its axis, and the only thing certain is everything changes. Man, they close the Astoria at the end of last summer. The place we earned our pedigree, scene of our victory, sanctuary in the center of London. Now they're building the railway to drag the vanquished to Versailles. And the sing-alongs go on, but they're singing different songs in rooms that we don't know on the other side of the city. In the stillness of the moment, it takes a Polaroid picture to capture our faces forever. The world is trying to touch on its axis. The only thing certain is everything changes. So honey, I just need a little time to take a little time with today, to save a moment, triumph and tragedy before it slips away.
nonsense away. Let go of the little distractions, how close to the ones that you love. 'Cause we won't all be here this time next year, so while you can take a picture of us. Let go of the little distractions, how close to the ones that you love. 'Cause we won't all be here this time next year, so while you can take a picture of us. Take a Polaroid picture. Take a Polaroid picture. Take a Polaroid picture. Please take a Polaroid picture. Take a Polaroid picture and keep it with you forever to remind yourself that everything changes. But there was this one time, there was this one time when things were okay.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So we've been, this is the last day of the UK tour, right? And, we've been all around, and everywhere I go, I always feel the need like I have to apologize for being a southerner. You know what I mean? Because I'm from Winchester. Is anyone here from down south? Yes, yes! I'm a sort of proxy Londoner as well. I actually live pretty near here, and my family's from near here as well. So it's very nice to be at essentially a hometown show, is what I'm trying to say here. And this song's about where I'm originally from. This song's about Winchester. But it's also, it's not just about that. It's about being from somewhere kind of off the beaten path, somewhere that isn't cool, you know what I mean? The kind of place hipsters don't come from. And it's, this song's called Wessex Boy. Let me tell you all a little story of the things I've found. Hanging out and drinking with my friends in the cathedral grounds. Late to dodging drunks as we dance along Jury Street. As we wander uptown to the railway, our friends to meet. Something about coming back to your hometown again. The place where you grew up and where your family's friends. And none of them still live here, but I got nowhere to go. I'm a Wessex boy, but when I'm here, I'm home. Let me tell you all a little story of the things I've lost. Huddling for warmth on the top step of the Barter Cross. Sitting on the benches by the bridges at the riverside. Counting down the hours for the buses because I missed my ride. Something about coming back to your hometown again. The place where you grew up and where you found your family's friends. No, none of them still live here, but I got nowhere to go. I'm a Wessex boy. I'm a Wessex boy, and when I'm here, I'm home. But one day I'll hear this song anonymous and sweet. Ringing out from a busker's guitar on the ancient city streets. I pause a while and smile before I continue on alone. And somebody else will sing the words, and I'll feel like I'm home. Here's your bit. Something about hometowns you never can escape. tragedies have told you to the face. The welling of nostalgia, the feeling kind of strange, cause despite the little changes, yeah, this place still feels the same. There's something about coming back to your hometown again, the place where you grew up and where you stand in front of friends. And none of them still live here, and I don't know where to go. I'm a Westerns boy.
Here we go.
I'm a Westerns boy. When I'm near, I'm home. So, did everybody catch the incredible Larry and his flask earlier this evening, ladies and gentlemen? Incredible band and good friends of ours. And then, of course, before Larry, all the way, you know, when I first met George, I asked him where he was from and he said Houston. I was like, fuck, okay. Anyway, all the way from London town, today's his last show with us on this run, but we fucking love him, he's completely amazing. Mr. George Frakes, ladies and gentlemen, come on! This song goes out to George for being a great fucking guitar player, a great singer, and a really lovely human being as well. This song's called Substitute. The first girl I fell for was a fair and faithful fighter. She smoldered with the will to save the world. I did my best to help her, yeah, I stood shoulder to shoulder on the front lines with my visionary girl. I wish that she cared for me, but in the end her ideologies occupied the fortress of her heart. I wrote her 15 songs, but still we had to part. And if music was the food of love, then I'd be a fat romantic slug. Music is my substitute for love. The last girl that I loved, she was a lone, lusty liar. She set my heart on fire, but she made me choke. Her beauty was a sight to see, but she didn't save it all for me. I found other fires by following the smoke. I wish that she had either cared for me or let me be, but she chased me from my mind and from my home. I wrote her 16 songs, but ended up alone. I never loved her, was really all that we need. Singing is never gonna save me. Music, it's my substitute for love. Well, I've had many different girls inside my bed, only one or two inside my head. These days I'll cuddle up to my guitar instead. But what I would give, not to stumble but to really fall in love. And I could substitute my singing for the sound of someone sleeping next to me. Thank you. All right, it's Thursday night, which means it's time to play a drinking song. Come on, join in if you know the words. This is an old one. I woke up on a sofa in an unfamiliar house, surrounded by sleeping folks that I didn't know. Failing to find my friends, I decided that it was clearly time to go. So I made my way out of the door and
quietly as I could. There was no one there I knew to say goodbye. Squinting in the sadly sobering sunshine of the Sunday morning light. Alright, sing along if you know the words. Cause I started the night with all my friends and I ended up alone. Oh yes, I started out so happy, now I'm hungover and down. It was about then that I realized I was halfway through the best years of my life. So I scanned the local landmarks trying to find out where I was, or maybe even find a bus back home. I was longing for a shower and for clean sheets and a charger for my phone. And suddenly it hit me, well, I got paid this Friday last. So I rifled through my pockets for some change. All I found was a packet of broken cigarettes and a sinking sense of shame. And that's a true story. Cause I started the night with all my friends and I ended up alone. Oh yes, I started out so happy, now I'm hungover and down. It was about then that I realized I was halfway through the best years of my life. And I had to ask myself, well, is it really worth it? Is any of this worth it? Nothing's fucking perfect, but I've yet to suits and dirty looks made me rack my brains. The real damage started to sink in. It had been quite a heavy weekend, but I could just about remember where I'd been. All right, last time all together, right? Oh yes, I started out so happy, now I'm hungover and down. I stood on a street corner and I felt a little sick. It was about then that I realized I was halfway through the first day of the week. Thank you. Alright, we're going to play another new song now, if that's okay. Mr. Matt Nazir. Oh, where have you gone? You're over there. Hi, Matt.
I'm over here in the darkness.
Let's hear it for Matt Nazir. Still in the dark. There he is. Matt, are you going to play an interesting instrument for us today?
I'm going to play a very interesting instrument.
What are you going to play, Matt?
This evening, Francis, I shall be playing the mandolin.
The mandolin, ladies and gentlemen. Do not fear it. Matt intends to use it for good rather than evil. As far as I'm aware. There it is, my guitar works. How about your mandolin?
Everything's going swimmingly, I think.
Oh, okay, give us a chord. What a lovely chord that was. Right, is anyone here familiar with a band called Motley Crue? What a bunch of dicks. That's what this song's about, sort of. It's not about that at all. Fuck it, this song's called Good and Gone. I have searched for you in the darkness of a dozen dingy dance floors. In countless queues of cafes in the suburbs, in the bedclothes of a thousand strangers' bedrooms. I have yearned for you in the airless hubs of international airports, in the hollow hell of many hundred hotels, in the solitary stillness of the early hours. I still do. Sometimes the things you need are right back where you started from. So fuck you, Hollywood, for teaching us that love was free and easy, for dressing all our daughters as princesses, telling tales that all had happy endings, and fuck you, Motley Crue, for charming us with access and with excess, for dragging us with all half happy endings, for dragging out the lowest drawing in everyone. Oh, fuck you. Sometimes the things you need are right back where you started from. Sometimes the things you need, they hang around a little while and they're good and gone. Just have a second try. I take the second call you made that night. Find myself an airport, find a credit card, find a flight or something, head back to the start. Sometimes the things I need are right back where I started from. Sometimes the things I need, they hang around a little while. Yes, it's good and gone. Thank you. Man is here on the mandolin, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so now here's the thing. I'm really, really bad with names. It's really not one of my skills, remembering what anybody's called. And somebody emailed me and sent me a really great request for this song, and I can't remember what your name is. But the good news is that everybody here can now claim that it was them. And if you enjoy the song, just tell your mates that it was you. How about that? Anyway, this is a really old song. I haven't played this song in forever, and hopefully I don't fuck this up. And it's for you, mystery requester. This song's called A Decent Cup of Tea. It hadn't been a day when everything had turned out right. She called me up and asked me to come over in the night, to make her cups of tea and listen quietly as she starts to list the latest list of bastards who have trampled on her heart. 'Cause she summers by my sea, but she winters without me. She cries into her tea that she's secretly lonely. And oh me, what am I to do? It's obvious to me she never seems to see. And see her in the nightclubs, I meet her in the bars, at rooftop after parties, and crammed into friends' cars. And we talk about the weather and how she drowns her pain in drink. And I nod and never ever dare to tell her what I think. 'Cause she summers by my seas, but she winters without me. And she cries into her tea that she's secretly lonely. And oh me, what am I to do? It's obvious to me, she never seems to see, that it's not about the days when everything is turned out right. Yeah, it's more about the moments when she calls me in the night to make her cups of tea and wash the weary worries from her head, and then to draw the pain out slowly as I slip her into bed. And I slip this information into all our conversations, but she never seems to listen. She never seems to see.
Anyway, would you welcome back to the stage the Sleeping Souls, please? Come on. How are you guys doing?
How are you doing?
Pretty good, huh?
Pretty good, huh?
Pretty good.
Anyway, this is a song. Where are we? Oh, yeah, this is a new song. Sorry, I'm just reading my set list. What the fuck is going on? This is a new song. Has anyone here seen a French film called Amelie ever in their life? Propaganda! Lies and propaganda from the romantic lobby. It's a really nice film, don't get me wrong, but it's just trying to convince you that love is real. This song's called Plain Sailing Weather. Just give me one fine day, plain sailing weather, and I can fuck up anything, anything. It was a wonderful life, we were together, and now I fucked up every little goddamn thing. Emily lied to me, this was supposed to be easy. Found that one damn person to help me fall asleep in the night. But sleeping gets tiring, and dog reminds me of dying. And as long as this feeble heart is still beating, you will find me rushing through every room, switching on all the lights. The problem with falling in love in late night bars is that there's always more nights, there's always more bars. The problem with showing in love of your scars is everybody's lover is covered in scars. So give me one fine day, plain sailing weather, I could fuck up anything, anything. It was a wonderful life when we were together, now I fucked up everything's got fractures. I felt faithless at the moment just before the dawn when everything falls apart. But baby, I didn't mean it for things to get desperate. Let's live my God, I let go of the rudder. Now we're drifting in the current away from one another. Give me one fine day, plain sailing weather, I could fuck up anything, anything. It was a wonderful life when we were together, but now I fucked up everything. Sailing weather, I could fuck up anything, anything. It was a wonderful life, we were together, now I fucked up every little goddamn thing, every little goddamn thing, every little goddamn thing, every little goddamn thing. Now I've been skirting round the rim, doing something brave. Just standing, but jumping in. We're turning circles into squares, laying down some bare facts like a burden I can't bear. And I can almost find the words. To the fire, and then when the fire is finished, scrape the ashes in a tin, take them down to London's drinking reservoirs and throw them in. So the snakes infinitesimal, and my arm also remains. Slide down 7 million throats into 7 million veins, and I will creep through their capillaries to the marrow of their bones. They will wake to bright new mornings, and wordlessly they'll know that I remain. Innocence, they will have me in their blood, and when they die they'll burn their bodies. I'll be buried in the mud, and I will creep through streams and rivers like a virus through a host, from the hamlets to the cities, from the rivers to the coast, and from there into the town across the great Atlantic Ocean. Ever onwards to the new world, through the water's gentle motion, until parts of me are part of every land, that's every sea, in the rain upon your crops, in the very air you breathe. Of these things that don't exist. Yeah, by Jewish boys with big ideas and scratches on their wrists. By a loving art of Ansel, God, a one who'd condescend to wash his hands down in the mire among the misery of men. Of my ever-turning circles, hanging timeless in the sky, like a dream catcher distracting from the fact of good and dry. But I place one foot before the other, confident because I know that everything we are right now, everything that was, that what Tyler, Woody Guthrie, Dostoevsky and Davy Jones have all dissolved into the ether and have caressed into my bones. And all the selling on the lines upon the backs of both my hands was carved into the details of to feed upon the sense of we remain. We are remembered. We remain. We are remembered. Swing love will be washed away in the rain. We remain. whiskey when I got the call. Yeah, my friend Lex was lying in the hospital. She'd been pretty sick for about half a year. She managed to start the end was going near. She dropped my present on the next London train. Found her laid up and in a lot of pain. Her eyes met mine and then I understood. Five more cars doesn't lean too good. Saddest one and sorry, sorry, little while. Tried to raise a mood and tried to raise a smile. Silenced all my ramblings with a shake of her head. To me close and listen, this is what she said. You'll live to dance another day. So now you have to dance for the two of us. Stop looking so food. Doctors, distant relatives, draining her blood. She said, I know I'm tired, I'm not finished just yet. You're dying for a drink or for a cigarette. So we hired some plan to book ourselves a cheap hotel. Sent to the city to raise some outlay. Waste to all the clothes and then where everyone else is obviously. You know we're good enough. You'll live to dance another day. So now you'll have to dance for the two of us. And Sarah called me up. She said that Lex had gone to sleep and wasn't waking up. And even though I knew that there was nothing to be done, I felt bad for not being there and now when she was gone. So I tried to think what Lex would want me to do at times like this when I was feeling blue. To gather up some friends to spread the sad, sad news. And we headed to the city for a drink or two. And we sang, we live to dance another day. It's just now we have to dance for one more of us. So stop looking so damn depressed and sing with all of your hearts. Long live the Queen.
Thank you. All right. How's everyone doing? We're still having ourselves a good time.
Yes.
We have a handful more songs left for you, if that's all right with you guys. Yeah? Now, the first of these, okay, I'm now going to destroy any remaining punk rock cred that I had. Anyway, I mean, if I had any left anyway. I've recently been on something of a health and fitness kick.
It shows. You loser.
Look at those, look at ripped.
Yes, good. Kiss the guns. Anyway, it's obvious, you know, the thing about it is that I'm trying to play shows and run around all fucking day every day, and I'm 30 fucking 1 years old, and god damn it, occasionally you need to help yourself out.
Just getting on.
But anyway, what I want to do, this next song that we're going to play is kind of a song about trying to get better from a bad place anyway. And with that in mind, and with, you know, bringing the spirit of everybody trying to improve themselves together, I've got a little something I want to try here. We tried this in the last couple of nights and it worked pretty well, and I figure that you guys are going to know how to do this as well. We're basically doing this to make me feel better about the fact that I've stopped laughing at people who do yoga, you know what I mean, and started doing fitness. Anyway, what I want you to do, when the chorus of this next song kicks in, I want everybody here to give me, I want you all to jog on the spot like you're doing a fitness routine, all right? Ben's the fitness instructor right here. Basically, you've got to get your knees high. And if you're feeling really adventurous, you can do this with your hands while you do it as well. It fucking kills you after about 30 seconds, I'm telling you.
Oh, really,
anyway, let's all do this together. And that includes the balcony as well, although don't fall off. That would be terrible. Anyway, let's see if we can get better together. This song's called Recovery. Blacking in and out in a strange flat in East London. Somebody I don't really know just gave me something to help settle me down, to stop me from always thinking about you. And you know your life is heading in a questionable direction when you're up for days of strangers and you can't remember anything except the way you sounded when you told me you didn't know what I should do. Like every other day, and just like every boring blues song, I get swallowed by the pain. So I fumble for your figure in the darkness just to make it go away. But you're not lying there any longer, and I know that that's my fault. So I've been pounding on the floor, and I've been calling up the walls. Been dipping in my darkness for serotonin boosters, silent in some kind of smell. It starts a long road up to recover. You said, well, darling, let's make a deal. If anybody ever asks us, let's just tell them we met in jail. And that's a story that I'm sticking to like a stony face to compass. But tonight I need to hear the truth. Am I ever getting through this? Yeah, you once sent me a letter that said if you're lost at sea, close your eyes and catch a time, my dear, and only think of me. But darling, now I'm sinking. I was lost and lost could be, and I was hoping you could drag me up and down here towards my recovery. Give me a sign, just a subtle little glimmer. Some suggestion that you'd have me if I could only make me better. I would stand a little stronger as I walk a little taller all the time. Cause I know you are a cynic, but I think I can convince you. Cause broken people can get better if they really want to. At least that's all I have to tell myself if I am hoping to survive. Long road up to recover. This will all be over. Give me someone, for I have sinned, and I know not where I should begin. And some days it feels like you just can't win, no matter what you do or say. Things didn't kill me, but I don't feel stronger. Life is short, but it feels much longer. When you lost that fight, yeah, you lost that hunger to pull yourself through the day. Here we go! If ever I stray from the path I follow, take me down to the English Channel. Throw me in where the water is shallow and drive me on back to shore. Serene life is cheap. As long as I've got me a place to sleep, clothes on my back and some food to eat, can't ask for anything more. So come on, everybody, sing a 1, 2, 3, 4. So we all have to use how we hold inside. Yeah, the worst little things that you never confide. Worst one of all.
you just can't hide? Is that you're ever quite as strong as the sound? So I'm sorry, baby, for the times I've hurt you. Sorry, friends, for the times I desert you. Most days it feels like I don't deserve you, but I wonder that you're all still around. Hey! Ever I stray from the path I follow, take me down to the English Channel. Throw me in where the water is shallow, drag me all back to shore. Love is free and life is cheap, as long as I've got me a place to sleep. Swim for her. So cause it's hard to remember. I could do this on my own. Alright, London, come on. Never I stray from the path I follow. Take me down to the English Channel. Throw me in where the water is shallow. Drag me on back to shore. Aye. Love is free and life is true. Outside my back is a food to eat. Now I surrender more. Now I surrender more.
The path I chose isn't straight and narrow. Wanders around like a drunken fella. Some days it's hard for me to follow, but if you got my back, I'll go on. If you've got my back, I'll go on. Thank you. All right, friends, we got time for at least one more song. So I want to see everybody singing, and I want to see everybody dancing, but most of all, we're going to count this one off and say 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Are you ready? I said, are you fucking ready? 1. I should confess that I am starting to get old. And the latest music that's all passing by and left me cold. All the kids are talking slang. I won't pretend to understand. All my friends are getting married, mortgages and pension plans. And it's obvious to my angry adolescent days are done. And I'm happy and I'm settled in the person I've become. But that doesn't mean settled up, sitting out the game. Time may change a lot, but some things they stay the same. I won't sit down and I won't shut up. And most of all, I will not grow up. I won't sit down and I won't shut up. And most of all, I will not grow up. I want to see more dancing, come on! Well, maturity is a laptop package deal. So it seems, ditching teenage fantasies, ditching all of your dreams, all your friends and peers and family. Solemnly tell you, you will have to grow up, be an adult. Yeah, be born and unfulfilled. Oh, but no one's yet explained to me exactly what's so great about saving. It's your road, then take it. But it's not the road for me. I won't sit down and I won't shut up. And most of all, I will not grow up. And I won't sit down and I won't shut up. And most of all, I will not grow up. And if all you ever do with your eyes Benjamin Lloyd on the electric mandolin. On the bass guitar, the one, the only, Mr. Taron Anderson. On the keys and the acoustic mandolin, your friend and mine, Mr. Matt Nazir. And holding it all together on the drums, Mr. Nigel Powell. There's a few more people that we have to mention right now. First of all, there's a whole load of people who work in my crew on making this show happen. And they work their fucking asses off from morning until night, and they don't come out on this stage and get a round of applause, but they fucking should do. So let's have a massive round of applause for my crew! Oh, I see. Are we doing the sitting down thing? Looks like we're doing the sitting down thing. It's kind of started already. Anyway, a couple more people to say hi to. First of all, as I mentioned earlier, it's his last night on the tour, so let's have a special round of applause for Mr. George Frakes! And then all the way from Oregon, USA, who could have missed? Larry and his flask! And then, last, but never least, on backing vocals, the good people of London Town, England. Come on, let's hear it for you guys. So here's how this works, okay? You guys stay sat down, and then when Nige comes in heavy with the drums and I play the guitar, you all jump up and you dance your fucking asses off. And I feel like you guys know the words to the end of this song as well, am I right? Okay. And here's why we're gonna do this. If the whole of the rest of tonight hasn't proved anything, then the next 30 seconds will just briefly prove one small thing. That we didn't just come here tonight to shout at each other and then just go home again. That actually, we're a couple of thousand individuals with different ideas and hopes and dreams and fears. And we all came here with our different baggage, but we left that baggage and those differences at the fucking door. And tonight we came in and just for a few hours, we are friends and we are equals and we have no barrier and no stage. And together we are more than the sum of our parts, right? That's what rock and roll's about. That's why we came here today. My name's Frank Turner. This is The Sleeping Souls. Thanks for coming out. We'll see you guys again. So I'll play, and you sing, the perfect way for the evening to begin. I'll play, and you sing, the perfect way for the evening to begin. Here we go! Won't sit down, won't shut up. Sit down, and most of all, I won't sit down, and won't shut up. You guys are very friendly. I feel like we should hang out more often. Anyway, listen, so we got a little something I want to talk about right now. Yeah, there it fucking is. Does anyone here know about this flag right here? Okay, can we get the flag up to the stage, please? Come and grab the flag. Okay, here we go.
Someone want to give me a hand with this? Do you want to help? Hey! Want to help hold it up? There we go.
Okay, let me tell you the story of this flag. Right? It's upside down. The idea behind this flag, right, was it was a fun little thing. We're going to make a flag that had the album artwork and the tour dates on. And then the first show, we'd give it out and see if it could make it to the last show without any of our help, right? And the idea, the point, are you rapping me in this? Good fucking Lord. There we go. I feel like Freddie Mercury. The idea is that we gave it out on the first show and it made it to the last show without any of my help, right? And the idea is to sort of prove that, you know, that people who don't know each other can kind of come together and do something, you know, something communal and something interesting. And we can make friends with each other. You know what I mean? That's the idea. And the idea was to disprove the cynics. Right? Now the thing is, on the first day of the tour, I was kind of in a shitty mood, and the flag arrived, and I was kind of like, oh, this is bullshit, it's not going to fucking work, no one's going to give a shit, someone's going to nick it, you know, whatever. And basically, I was the cynic on day one, and we gave it out, and God fucking damn it, have I been proved wrong about that. All right? I got photographs, I've got to take this off in a minute, I'll keep it on for a minute. I've got photographs of this thing crossing the English-Scottish border. I've got photographs of it on the battlements of York Castle, at Leicester train station, in the village where I grew up in Hampshire, at the railway inn in Winchester, fucking everywhere. And I mean, the people who've taken it around, thank you so much, you're the fucking best. I really appreciate it. So, now the thing with the flag, what we're gonna do with the flag after today is we're gonna auction it off starting tomorrow, and we're gonna raise some money for some homeless charities for shelter and people like that, and we're gonna give the good money to a good cause. But it's kind of warmed the cockles of my heart. And to celebrate the fact that it made it all the way to London successfully, I'm going to play a song that I don't really play very much anymore. And fuck it. Let's play it anyway. You guys can sing along. This song's called The Ballad of Me and My Friends. Everybody's got themselves a plan. And everybody thinks they'll be the man, including the girls, the musicians who lack the friends to form a band, the singer-songwriters, the rest of us are DJs or official club photographers. And tonight I'm playing another Nambuka show. So I'm going through my phone book, texting everyone that I know, and quite a few I don't, whose numbers found their way into my phone. But they might come along anyway, you never really know. Here we go! None of this is going anywhere. And pretty soon, when we sold our souls, but you're all about the destination, and take a fucking flight. We're going nowhere slowly, but we're seeing all the sights. Come on! Yes, I'm definitely going to hell, but I'll have all the best stories to tell. Thank you very much. That was fun. All right, we have a handful more songs, if that's okay. This next one, I want to talk about this for 2 seconds. Basically, it's a kind of a weird and interesting and exciting time for me at the moment, and with the albums doing really well, there's a new record, there's new people on board. That's fucking great. I appear to be in a battle with Michael Bublé and Will.i.am, which is...
Yeah!
which is the plot to a really sexy sitcom. Or something, I don't fucking know. Who gives a shit? The point is that there's more people, there's new people around, and that's great, but I keep meeting people who think I'm releasing my debut album or some shit, you know what I mean? And it's kind of important to me that people know about the previous records, you know, and about the things that done and where I've been and all that shit. And it's also important that the people... People coming on board now, everybody's welcome. What I do will never be a cool club. It's never going to be elitist, and everybody is always going to be welcome through the doors of my shows, okay? However, it is also important to make the people who've been supporting me since day one aware that I fucking know about it, and that I care, and that I'm aware that I'm up here because you guys gave a shit since the early days. So, I've also got a ton of friends and family here this evening who I can't name everybody by name, but I want to play this next song. This song goes out to everyone for giving a shit, and in particular for Dave and Jay for fucking backing me up since day one. This song's called I Knew Proof Rock Before He Got Famous. It's a begin in the beginning. We're lovers and we're losers. We're heroes and we're pioneers. And we're beggars and we're choosers. We're skirting around the edges of the ideal demographic. We're almost on the guest list, but we're always stuck in traffic. We've watched our close associates up and play their parts. They're chatting up the it girls and they're tearing up the charts. While we were paying with coppers to get our rounds under the bar. We're the C team with the almost famous old friends of the stars. Justin is the last of the great romantic poets. He's the only one among us who is ever gonna make it. And we planned the revolution from a cheap Southampton bistro. I don't remember details, our English boys with banjos. Jay is us and George, and he's standing on a wooden chair. And he sings songs, he slays dragons, and he's losing all his hair. And Adam is the resurrected spirit of Graham Parsons, implanting Sam Rhinestone and living in South London. And no one's really clear about Tommy's job description. It's pretty clear he's vital to the whole damn operation. Dave Danger smiles at strangers, trees the safest girl I know. Zoe and Hobbs will scamper up to victory in the city we call home. We won't change our ways. We will proud remain. When the glory fades, your life. I am sick and tired of people who are living on the playlist. They're waiting to be famous. They're wondering why they do this. I know I'm not the one who is eventually optimistic.
Try this.
dressing as rock stars. There's just people who play music, and some of them are just like us, and some of them are dicks. So quick, turn off your stereo, pick up that pen and paper. Yeah, you could do much better than a skinny half-assed English country singer. Come on! Cause we write love songs and sing, and we did politics and sing. We sing songs about our friends and even our love. So jam the stars now and take up your guitars. Hey, yay, hey, yay, friends and Romans, countrymen. Hey, yay, hey, yay, punks and skins and journeymen. Hey, yay, hey, yay, my sisters and my brethren. The time is coming near. Come, yay, to soulless corporate suckers' tops. Toilets are good, towing stops. Come yay to Benjamin's bars and bunker squats. The sound is ringing clear. Now who'd have thought that after all, something as simple as rock and roll would save us all? Now who'd have thought that after all, it was rock and roll. Hey, 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 hey. Now anybody can take the stage. Hey, 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 hey. Make miracles on minimum wage. Hey, 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 hey. These rock songs of the modern age will hold us in their arms. Right here, right now, Elvis brings his children home. Right here, right now, you never have to feel alone. Save us all. Now who'd have thought that after all, it was rock and roll. Alright, London! Has everyone still got one more fucking sing-along inside them? Are you guys gonna sing? Is the balcony gonna fucking sing? Once more with feeling! Do you still believe? Cause I still believe in the saints. Yeah, in Jerry Lee and in Johnny and all the greats. Everybody, I still believe. Thank you and good night.